I don't think it should, but if there has to be a different system, then it needs to be looked at. It needs to be approached differently. That's what we're arguing.
No, I understand that. I totally agree, but I don't agree that we should abolish the system completely.
I'd agree. I'd say it's one of those things. Civil rights.
You can never get rid of racism.
You're right, especially
but you
not
need
overnight.
A system, but you do need a system to prevent racism from taking place.
You're right. I agree. You're not going to get rid of it overnight. It's a gradual system. But in a gradual system, in a gradual, your policies where you're trying to have everyone have equal civil rights. And that's what you're going for. That's our end result. And in a system, it has to be gradual. Like, if you expect change, it has to change. You know, like, the system has to change with it. And that's not what's happening.
That's true.
That's our issue.
I will admit that. Like, it really hasn't. But like, I can't say that to completely abolish a system that does prevent employers. Even today, even with affirmative action, there is still like employers that say take two names. One person is equally as qualified as
John Smith or DeAndre Johnson.
Yeah, they'll pick John Smith most of the time.
Yeah, I would agree with that. And unfortunately, it takes time. It takes time to change it. You know, we're not going to change it.
But with affirmative action, I mean, it forces them to have.
Well, that's the issue too. It's like in with the 2003 ruling, the thing that came out of the ruling. The way they get around it is by collecting statistics. That's why you check a box that says Caucasian, you check a box that says Hispanic. That's how they get around that. But technically, you're not supposed to have a quota. You can't meet a quota for admissions. The top 10% is supposed to be blanket, but it's not.
Just in Texas?
No, there's a few states that do it. Texas, obviously we speak Texas because we're here. But I know Texas, Florida, Michigan, California, a few of the smaller states like Rhode Island, they all have similar policies. But here it's just...
But they get around it. They get around it.
It's just one of those things where you have to take an honest look at it and say, does this work? Is this our most effective approach to the issue?
Yeah.
And it's not. It's not.
Oh, yeah, you got a point. I will say that. That's
so
a valid
what needs
point.
To happen is that, and there's obviously there's so much other stuff that we're worrying about right now. But
yeah.
Someone needs to take a good long look, especially in a budget crisis. Is this feasible? Is this economically feasible right now to say that we have to set aside this amount of whatever for what we consider affirmative action, meaning the mandatory acceptance of minority groups.
That's ridiculous.
You know?
That's ridiculous. You're just surprised that Texas has one of the best economies left.
Well, it's true. I think 2 years ago, we were the eighth largest economy in the world. I mean, that's crazy, you know? Sure, we have the budget shortfall, but there's a lot of perks we have in Texas compared to, say, California.
Yeah.
You know, or something. But I agree.
Sure.
I totally agree, man. Yeah, so, but that's...
No, but that's yeah, we're just talking about
yeah, dude. I always appreciate when people talk as
no, I don't
drive by.
No, I hate people who just yell at you and, like, they don't even consider what your opinion
I've always...
Like, I mean...
Debate,
no, dude, it's great. As long as there's no anger in it or
right,
anything, you know, because we understand each other.
That's
so.
The only way we're going to approach problems.
Yeah, for sure.
So.
And you know what? You actually, you did educate me. I didn't know that much about affirmative action. And it's true that we do need to change, tweak it at least, and it needs to change with the times. But I still believe that we do need a system to regulate racism.
So it's done, man. I agree. Yeah, that was good talking.